here tonight to talk about the mathematician Paul Erdős. I wrote a book about Paul, and Joel worked very closely with him. I'm curious, what did Paul mean to you?
Well, Paul was, is, will be the center of my mathematical life. I mean, and I'm not alone. I mean, there are hundreds, really thousands of people that can say the same thing. In large part, of course, it was because of his theorems. But also, as I've gotten older, I realized that I feel I have to use religious terms. It was a spirit. It was the spirit he had when he did mathematics that remains part of me, and that I hope I give somewhat to my students. But let me ask you a question, Paul. So I mean, you really seem to have a wonderful feeling for what mathematics is about, and yet, you know, you're not a mathematician. And so, what is it about? There must be something about mathematics that drew you to be interested in mathematics, and maybe you can tell me what that was.
Sure. I mean, I think many people think mathematics is just about counting. And I was lucky enough early on to read Martin Gardner's column in Mathematical Games. Yeah. And even more fortunate, my first job out of college was editing his column. So yes. I sort of learned mathematics not in the classroom, but in the sly. And then it really, to me, I mean, it's about beauty. Yeah. It's about sometimes finding order in areas where you think are random or chaotic, and you find some kind of pattern or something there that you didn't notice at first. And I think that must be incredibly rewarding as a practicing mathematician. Yes. When you find that.
Yeah, it certainly is. It's interesting about Martin Gardner, because for me, when I was in high school, I loved Gardner's column, and it told me what, like you said, what mathematics was. Something more than counting. There was more than adding up large piles of numbers. And I wrote him a letter once. I had looked at some kind of thing involving Venn diagrams, and I was just a high school kid. And he wrote me a nice reply, and he told me, and it was such a powerful thing. Well, we're here to honor Erdős, but it's nice to say some good words about Martin Gardner, who was a special person.
I think, you know, one of the things to me that was amazing about Paul Erdős is, first of all, his persistence in wanting to solve problems. I mean, it didn't matter to him whether he was the person that solved it. He was this kind of Johnny Appleseed that ran around and, in many ways, turned mathematics into a social occasion. I mean, last I checked, he had 511 collaborators that he worked with.
This was really his sense that, like you say, it really didn't matter who proved the result. There were these open questions. There was the truth that was there, and we had to discover it. And whenever anyone did make the discovery, when anyone was able to prove the theorems, then it was a cause for celebration. And it gave a very nice feeling, let's say, in opposition to a competitive world. It was a very supportive world. And the Erdős world that I was so proud to be part of was a very supportive world. When one of us achieved a result, we were all so happy for that person. It was very, very, very rewarding indeed. Paul was always interested in young people. He had a special word, epsilons, which meant a young child. In mathematics, epsilon is usually used for a small number, and he used it for a child. And he was very interested in talented young people and very supportive of them, both in his native Hungary and throughout the world. And this feeling persists. Indeed, the American Math Society now has an Epsilon Fund named after this, which supports high school camps for talented youngsters. And I like to think this continues. And through books such as Paul's, young people can hear about the spirit. And then when they get a little bit older, they can understand some of his beautiful mathematics.
I think he's an inspiration to those of us who are getting older too, because he managed to do what he loved best, doing mathematics, until the age of 83. I mean, he sort of defied the conventional wisdom that mathematics is a young person's game. So, I mean, I find that very inspiring that he could go through 83 years of his life doing what he really enjoyed.
You know, when I started out, it was a terrible time in America. It was the late 60s, Vietnam War. And there was this phrase, do your own thing. And it was a very powerful phrase. And we all said it, but Paul did it. And he did it his whole life long. He had a very strong will. He had things he wanted to do. He wanted to do mathematics. He also talked about other things, but he wanted to do mathematics. And he managed to live his life on his terms. And even today, I think of it, it's just a remarkable life that he was able to do this. A very inspirational life. And I think inspiring to new generations as well.